last weekend, they sang live for a place in your hearts.
You are a superstar.
Genius.
The next big girl group in the UK.
I think you're absolutely fantastic.
But one act had to leave the competition for good.
The act with the fewest votes and leaving the competition is Candy Rain.
Tonight, battling for your vote once again, Danny and the girls, Lucy Jones, Rachel Adedeji, and Stacey Solomon.
My girls have been working really hard this week. We're back and we're coming out fighting.
Cheryl and the boys, Joe McKeldry, Lloyd Daniels, and Ricky Loney.
All three of my boys did an amazing job last week, and I'm sure tonight they're going to do not only themselves, but me really proud.
And Simon and the over 25s, Ollie Murs, Daniel Johnson, and Jamie Archer.
Tonight, this is about making a statement, and each one of them are better than they were the week before. So I'm feeling confident right now.
And Louie and the groups, Miss Frank and John and Edward.
Louis's not here tonight, but we're going to make him proud.
We know that Louis believes in us, and we are going to do it for him tonight.
It's time!
We've thrown down the gauntlet, but wait till you see what's coming this week.
To face... the music!
I cannot wait for tonight.
Factor Live Finals, your X Factor weekend. It starts right here. So we are seconds out, round two. Tonight we have another no holds barred super heavyweight bare knuckle contest for you as the 11 remaining finalists battle it out to stay in the competition and keep their dreams alive. And if last weekend's contest was anything to go by, it is going to be an absolute corker tonight. Sadly, for obvious reasons, Louis isn't here, but his three amigos are here. They're revved up, they are raring to go. It's the X Factor judges!
Danny, Simon, and Cheryl!
Looking keen and mean, Simon, the thorn amongst the roses. Now, if you thought last week was going to be tough, this week we have cranked up the pressure. Tonight, the theme is divas. Each act is going to have to raise their game as they tackle songs by some of the biggest female voices on the planet. Tonight, people, we're talking Beyonce, we're talking Aretha, we're talking Christina, we're talking Leona, hang tough, Leona, Tina Turner and Whitney. And Whitney... with good reason, because tomorrow night we have a massive X Factor exclusive. She is back. Whitney Houston, the Queen of the Divas, returns for her first British performance in a decade. Simon, this is going to be some weekend. We've got Whitney performing, we've got the people here, we've got Cheryl performing, we've got you trying to put Cheryl off. It's going to be great. And I know the contestants had a big surprise yesterday as well, right?
You know, I've got to say, it is an absolute... It is is a total, for me, it's an honour to have Whitney here. And I also want to welcome somebody who was my mentor. He is undoubtedly the most successful guy in the music business in history, the legendary Clive Davis. This is the man who discovered Whitney Houston amongst many others, and I'm very, very grateful, Clive, for you being here tonight. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Pleasure to have you witness. I know that Clive and Whitney met all the contestants yesterday. We'll see that later on, but let's kick things off. This week, we are starting with the girls. So, let's head over to Miss Danny Miller.
Opening the show in true diva style, it's our Welsh diva, and Whitney wouldn't have it any other way. It's your lovely Lucy Jones.
I would buy your record in the morning.
Can't hit those big notes, at the moment it's a confidence thing. Lucy!
Just before I walked out on stage last Saturday, I was so nervous. But as soon as the doors opened, it all went, and it was just the most amazing feeling I've ever had.
What Leona is capable of doing is hitting those huge notes, and you didn't.
Simon's comment was always going to come because Leona's just out of this world, and it's because, you know, he was her mentor.
I know Leona is incredible, but I think Lucy can be just as good.
When I was a kid, I was always in the school choir. I was always in the school plays and stuff. Looking back on it, it's those experiences that have made me want to do what I am doing. So we was just doing some vocal warm-ups around the piano and Whitney Houston and Clive Davis walked in. I've never felt like that in my life. I couldn't breathe. I don't think I breathed for about a minute. And then I sing a Whitney Houston song to her. That is what dreams are made of.
All right.
Just have fun with it and yes. Just let loose and be loose.
Don't be afraid to open it up either, you know what I'm saying? How will I know? You know what I'm saying? Just get to it, you know what I'm saying? Let it out. Open your mouth and just let that voice come out. It's in there.
Nothing's ever going to feel like that ever again.
Tonight we're seeing a different side to Lucy. We know she can sing, but now we are going to see that she can really dance.
Get them relaxed so you don't have to hit them hard. There's so much going on stage for Lucy, and this could be the thing that really gets her.
Hitting all those really high notes and dancing. Pressure's on.
I'm not worried, I know she's going to be amazing.
I'm just praying that the judges are going to like this new side of me that they've not seen before. I need to get this right tonight, because I need to prove that I can do it.
Lucy Jones!
Continue.
in high heels and sing, and I thought you did a great job of it, but for me there is just a little something not quite connecting yet, and I don't know what it is.
I think you two are going to constantly have issues for whatever reason's going on here. But that's the way it is. You are a very, very different artist from the person we saw a few weeks ago. I'm going to actually hand you some credit, though, tonight, because... at least you made an attempt to be younger. It was a good performance. You're looking like a pop star. You're never going to be Whitney Houston, so I think it was sort of silly what it was. You can't sing those big notes. But if Danny can connect you with the right type of pop song now, I actually think you're going to do quite well. I was quite impressed.
There's a lot of love in the room for Lucy tonight, and I'm very excited about that. And it was amazing open to the show. Whitney would have been very proud of that. She said, there was a diva in there and you let her out tonight. Beyonce, Christina, whoever it is, they started somewhere and they travelled to where they are now, and then they get accoladed as diva, but you are on your way.
All right. A mixed bag of compliments there. I mean, I guess the dancing was the thing you wanted to bring in this week as well, right?
Yeah, definitely, yeah. And I'm really glad I did it. I don't know how it looked, but it felt really fun, and that's it.
You know what? I mean, I want to ask you, you know, I'm probably going to ask everyone this tonight, how did it feel to meet Whitney Houston?
I've got to say thank you to whoever sorted that out, because who meets the hero? I mean...
I did that, it was me. Yeah, I sorted that out. You're more than welcome. 0901 61 61 101 is the number that will ensure Lucy is back singing again next week. Sky and Virgin Media viewers can vote by using the red button. Do not do it now. Lines won't open until all 11 acts to perform. Calls cost 35p from a BT landline. From other networks may be higher, and from mobiles will be considerably more. Votes cast before the opening time won't be counted, but may still be chosen. One more time, everyone, it's Lucy Jones! Woo! And we are off to a flyer. Coming up, he was roundly praised last week. Can Essex boy Ollie up the ante as he takes on Tina Turner? Plus, our very own trio of divas. We find out if Miss Frank are the real deal. We are back before you know it. To the X Factor Live Finals 2009. The place is packed to bursting with friends and family and supporters. We've got John and Edward down there. We've got Ollie's over here. Who are we cheering for tonight? And if you've got a favourite, don't forget you can join the live chat at the action unfolds, itv.com/X Factor. Up next, the first of the over 25s. So we go to the Divas Diva, Mr. Simon. I'll have my water at room temperature. Cap.
Thank you very much. Okay, we are. To the talent now is Ollie Murs. You remind me of Robbie. You've got that charm about you.
Saturday night was great. It was all a bit surreal, you know. It was a little bit like, oh, my God, normally I'd be sitting at home watching this on the telly. She's the one. Sunday night, when we were waiting for the results, you know, I was stood there on my own. And then as soon as you hear your name, just all that comes out, you know, and you just can't help your reaction.
Ollie!
Like scoring a goal at Wembley. It's like,
yeah. I'm sorry, mate, yeah!
When I was a kid, you know, we used to sit in the living room singing pop songs in the charts. Probably where I learned all my moves from, really. We used to just take things off the telly, and that's probably where I got all my moves today. If I do well in this competition, there could be kids out there singing along to my songs in the charts. It's just mind-blowing.
Hello.
When I went in to see Whitney, that's literally, I was like, oh, my God, that's Whitney Houston. You take the good along with the bad. See Whitney sort of bobbing along to the song whilst I was singing was just incredible.
I think you did real well. You do dig deep. You do feel the tempo and the song.
And the part of Tina that made it so incredible, hey, 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 hey. But she sang, you know, with that feeling. Yeah, use the Tina thing,
use my shoulders. She gave me some really good feedback, and so I just want to make sure that I use the advice they've given me and really put that into my performance tonight.
Ollie could be in over his head tonight with the Diva song, but this is his opportunity to prove that he can do it, I suppose.
I've got to work out the transition from Tina Turner to Ollie from Essex, who used to sell electricity 3 months ago. Difficult. But I think we cracked it.
To rehearse this song has been hard work for Ollie.
Got to go out there and pretty much be a diva, you know, really give it, strut my stuff, really give it everything I've got, because I still feel like I've got a lot to prove.
Something on my mind. Won't somebody please, please tell me what's wrong? Ah!
You're just a fool in all your love. You got the reason to live in this world. You take the good along with the bad. Sometimes you're happy and sometimes you're sad. You know you love it. When I'm such a good man. Now listen, he's got me smiling when I should be ashamed, and got me laughing when my heart is in pain. Hey, oh now, I must be a fool, 'cause I'll do anything you want me to do. Now how come you're just a fool? You know you're in love. You got the patience to live in this world. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Sometimes you're happy, sometimes you're sad.
Sing it one time. Like it is, huh. I got my nose up in, and that's no lie. I'm gonna keep us satisfied. Hey.
You're just a fool, you know you're in.
Yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah.
One more time.
Sometimes you're happy,
sometimes you're sad. Mm, you know you love it, you can't understand why you treat you like a fool.
And I know this is going to make Simon really smug, which is quite annoying, but I think that was the best performance you've done so far. On paper, that shouldn't have worked. Tina Turner song, I don't think that many people are familiar with, but you absolutely smashed it. Well done.
Ollie, this was the person we fell in love with a few months ago during your first audition. I don't mean literally I've fallen in love with you, because I haven't. But, you know, it was fun, it was different, it wasn't what we saw previously, which was karaoke, it was original, and this is why all the contestants want to be mentored by me. I have to say that. Right? No, Ollie, I'm kidding. That was really, really, really good, and in a different league. Fantastic. Good for you.
Man! Way to go, Ol. Like, across the board, mate, great comments. What are your thoughts?
I'm just so happy. Simon, Stan Innovation as well. I'm just so chuffed to bits, you know. And thank you, all these guys, as well. It's fantastic.
Awesome. Have you got a name for that dance step? What is it, the Ollie Shuffle? What's going on there?
I don't know, it just feels, I just feel it when I dance.
But you come alive when you move, don't you?
I do, yeah, so.
Good man. 0901 616 1102 is the Ollie's number. the one he would love you to call, but lines weren't open to all 11 acts that perform, so wait until then. For now, this is Ollie Moores. Only two groups left in the competition. The first of those is up now. It's Miss Frank.
Together you are powerhouse. You've got so much more.
I think you girls have got huge potential. Watch this space.
Performing on Saturday in front of millions of people was just incredible.
We went out there, it was like the lights hit us and Miss Frank zoomed into our bodies and got...
What's surprising is the two bookends were actually very good tonight.
What I actually think he meant was that we actually did come together as a group, and that was exactly our aim, and we're going to take that as a compliment. This has just been all of our dreams for so long. As a kid, my dad took me to this singing class and he thrust me on stage. I realised that that is just where I wanted to be.
When I was six, we got a karaoke machine and whole family trying to sing, passing around the mic, but I wouldn't let it go.
Well, it's been my dream ever since I was a kid. My granddad pulled me up in church to sing a Christian song. I just saw Michael Jackson on TV and I came out and beat it.
Hello, ladies.
We love Whitney. Whitney is the queen of pop. We won't let go.
I love the harmonies. This is actually how I do it in my show.
Really?
I would urge you to get closer to each other.
You're very strong.
Thank you.
You really have a very sweet quality to your voice. Your voice is almost like an angel's.
Three really positive comments.
We were like, really? Louis hasn't been here for us in person, but we've been in contact with him via the phone, and he's just said to us, we need to up our game this week. We need to show that we're a group even more.
If Miss Frank gets this performance right tonight, it will be the best of the night.
These girls have to come out tonight and show us what's uniquely special about them to survive.
Act like a group, sing like a group, and prove that you're good singers.
We completely trust Louis, so we're going to go out there tonight and we're going to do this for him.
I have to say that I think the magic comes together when you're physically together. You feel like you're more confident around each other when we were seeing you chatting before the performance, and you get along so well. I felt a little bit you were too spaced out in the beginning of the song. So just keep it together, react with each other.
You girls, out of everyone in this competition, have had probably the toughest job. You've had to do a lot of adapting to bring it together. And tonight you proved that rudely last week Simon called two of you bookends. There's no bookends in this band. You can all sing. And tonight you proved that. You haven't had your mentor physically here with you this week, so good on you, girls. Well done. Job well done.
Girls, taking everything into account, the solo vocals, and when you eventually came together, I thought it was mainly terrible. When you hear it back, you'll understand what I'm saying. You were out of tune, particularly towards the end. You didn't feel like a group. To me, it was like...
Do you know what, Simon? To be fair, right, it took us, like, no, literally, about 2 years to feel like we properly connected with harmonies. Properly connected with harmonies and chemistry and everything like that. They haven't had their mentor physically here this week.
Doesn't
and I think
matter.
Under the circumstances, they did an incredible job.
We can all live in the bubble called X Factor. In the real world, and I promise you, you're going to agree with me when you watch this back, wasn't good enough, and I think you're going to be in real trouble tonight.
Hey! Well, firstly, Whitney liked him, and she's really good.
Well, I think Whitney, watching it back, will be agreeing with Mr. Cowell.
Girls, I want to get your opinion. Obviously, it's, you know, tough to hear that from Simon. What are your thoughts?
I mean, we just take on board all what the judges have said, and obviously it has been a tough ride for us. We are a new group and we are trying every single day. We're practicing every single day to try and do this. I mean, we get on so well as friends, and just to be in a group, I think it's just a blessing as it is.
Yeah, it's a big ask, isn't it? That, you know, we chat three people together.
Yeah, but yes. Dermot, know, what they should have done is that they should have worked out an original version of the song rather than a copycat Whitney Houston version, and that was the problem. There was no originality.
Okay, 0901-6161-103. Remember to call if you think Miss Frank delivered it on the Diva front. Lines will be open at the end of the show, so contend yourselves until then. Ladies, great job, I thought. Thank you very much, Miss Frank. Feisty tonight. Coming up, Geordie Joe tackles a massive Whitney hit, and after last week's final showdown, Rachel attempts to prove you why she shouldn't be in that position again. We'll see you in three.
This week, we're offering you the chance to win an Xbox 360 with membership for points, this stylish netbook, a portable DVD player and iPod Touch, a digital camera, plus a pair of tickets to an X Factor live show. And that's not all. Every time you enter the competition, you'll be automatically entered into our X Factor draw at the end of the series, to win a whopping £50,000. For your chance to win, simply watch this clip and guess the missing word. What's the missing word? Call 090-4959-6979. Calls cost £1 from BT Landline, some other networks may be higher, and for mobiles will be considerably more. Or text the missing word to 84066. Text costs £1 plus one standard network rate message. Sky and Virgin Media viewers can enter by pressing the red button now. Or enter online for free at itv.com. Entrance must be 18 or over and lines close at 6:30 p.m. on Saturday the 24th of October. Entries made after the closing time won't be counted but may still be charged. Good luck.
Welcome back to the X Factor Live Finals. It is Diva Night. Let's see if our crowd are in Diva. Are we enjoying it tonight? So demanding. Okay, the ante well and truly has been up as the acts are tackling big female songs. Next, it's the girls again and Miss Danny Minogue.
This is the girl, Rachel Adedeji.
Job well done.
I may have underestimated you.
Singing for survival is Rachel.
No.
Leaving the competition is Candy Rain.
Being in the bottom two after the first live shows was just horrible. I was so upset.
I was really shocked when Rachel was in the bottom two last week because she didn't deserve to be there.
When I was singing for Survival, I nearly just broke down. In my head, I was thinking, like, my dreams could have been over, and I just thought, go for it and just do the best you can.
Candy Rain.
When Dermot said that Candy Rain were going home, I couldn't believe I've been given another chance. You know, I was so relieved. I've been singing since the age of five. My mum and dad used to put on their tracks like Barry White, Celine Dion, and I used to run around the house and make up routines and sing along. And I performed in various theatres. I just thought, I love this, I want to do this, you know? When Whitney walked in, I couldn't believe I just dropped to the floor. I couldn't control myself.
Baby, you thought I would wait for you.
Oh, wow.
Whitney and Clive clapped for me.
I enjoyed that. That was absolutely, you're excellent.
In this crowd, you're coming out fighting.
Oh.
I was nervous only with the read of that first line because you didn't give any signal that you would take control of that song.
If I don't know that first line, I could throw away the whole song. And that could be it. And I really can't afford to do that this week.
And you're really...
Oh, my God. To sing for Whitney Houston, man. Absolutely amazing.
Her confidence has taken a huge knock. So what has Danny done? Given her a Beyoncé song.
Rachel's an absolute fighter. She's going to come back. She's not going to be in the bottom two again.
And being in the bottom two knocks my confidence a lot. Tonight, I have to deliver.
Even just for a day, I'd roll out of bed in the morning and throw on what I wanted and go. If I were a boy,
that could have either made you crumble or made you come out fighting, and you came out fighting tonight, girl. Well,
I liked it. I didn't love it, if I'm being honest with you. And I'll tell you why, because once again, it was too close to the original. It was a bit. And I don't know what's happening with you at the moment. It's like Danny isn't quite getting your personality out enough. I'm frustrated, to be honest with you.
You know what? I think that Simon would have loved it if you were in his category. But that was a fantastic performance.
Firstly, thanks for wearing those heels, man. You're making me look short, or shorter. secondly, great feedback from the judges. Lovely. Great to see that Danny, that's like water off. Simon's like water off a duck's back to you now. He's just like, he just laughed about it.
Water, duck,
what are your thoughts? Because I know you really wanted to come back fighting tonight.
Yeah, totally. I mean, I'm pleased with the comments. And Simon, I need to get him to love me, man. Next week, Simon. Next week, seriously, if I'm here next week, I will make sure you love me, Simon.
No, Rachel, with respect, it's got nothing to do with me. Actually, it has, actually, but it's got more to do with the audience who vote. Yeah. That's what it's all about.
Well, let's find out. She was in the bottom two last week. She didn't like it one little bit. 0901 6161 104. Then I'm going to call when line's open to make sure it doesn't happen again. For now, Rachel and Energy.
Thank you.
All right, one category we haven't heard from yet, and that's the boys. So we go to their mentor, Cheryl Cole.
Yes, 1st of May boys up to Nate. It's May Little, Geordie Joe.
Absolutely brilliant.
Singing for the first time last week on that stage was just absolutely amazing. Tell me a story. The music came on, it was like electric. It was absolutely the best night of my life.
I'm really proud of Joe, he's my little northeast soldier.
And I've always liked to get up and sing. Did used to like to put skirts on, which is quite embarrassing. Each to their own. My grandma would always be dancing around the sitting room and I'd be singing in the background. It was a bit podgier then. I even remember going to Austria on holiday, trying to recreate the Wham! Last Christmas video. More just standing around the piano, and then in walks Whitney Houston with Clive Davis. I'm still lost for words to describe how I felt. It was just amazing.
Take your time. Don't be nervous.
I'll try.
Sing it from your heart, okay?
How I sang that song to her, I actually don't know. And I was singing the song that he produced and that she sang.
Absolutely beautiful.
He's feeling the lyric.
Yes, he is.
And that's what I look for.
And just hold the note straight. And now I know.
I'm definitely going to take that advice from Whitney Houston. I mean, she knows what she's talking about. Whitney's going to be watching the show, and that is, like, big-time pressure.
Joe has got no problem singing Whitney Houston. If I thought he did have, I wouldn't have given him a Whitney Houston song.
If he makes this week work with this song, then we've all got a problem.
When I step out onto that stage tonight, I'm going to give it everything I've got because I don't want to be in that bottom two tomorrow night and I don't want to be going home.
Joe McElderry!
Something on my mind. You see, I haven't been the same since that cold November day. We said we needed space, but all we found was an empty place. And the only thing I learned is that I need you desperately. So here I am. Please tell me, oh, where do broken hearts go? Can they find their way home? I look in your eyes and I know that you still care.
auditions, you nailed it. First show, you've nailed it. Second show. And when Whitney said just sing from the heart, I don't think there's anything else that you would do.
Joe, it actually pains me to say this, but that was note perfect. I have to hand it to you. You take on one of the big Whitney songs. How old are you, 18, 19?
Yeah, 18.
The only criticism I'm going to give you is that you've got to raise your shoulders a bit, OK? And you've got to learn how to perform a bit better, because if you can sing like that at your age, you've got a great future ahead of you. But now... it's like little older sister. You've now got to learn how to perform.
OK.
Right?
Yep.
But great, great vocal.
Whitney Houston said to you, that was absolutely beautiful, and I love you to bits, Joe. Well done.
Thank you.
Wow! Un, deux, trois. Ticked! Simon was singing along, we saw it on camera. I just want to go, Clive, you produced that song. Two thumbs up for that? Would you have
thumbs up.
There we go.
Buddy! Feedback just keeps getting better and better for you. I know we're in the early stages of the competition, but you've got to be happy.
I can't believe it. I'm actually speechless. I've just had such a great time tonight, and I just can't believe the comments I've got.
Brilliant stuff. And Simon, go for it.
One final piece of advice. Maybe burn the films we saw before.
Oh. Yeah, man, you look great. You like, were quite big when you were 16, but now you like look really cool. OK. 0901 61 61 105, the all-important number to see those Geordie eyes smiling and still in the competition. But do remember, lines won't open till the end of the show. It's Joe McElderry! I want what he eats. Coming up, there were fireworks flying after his performance last week. Let's see if Daniel will rise above it after the break. We'll see you in three. Welcome back to the X Factor and Divas Night. As you have seen, all our acts this week have had the honour of working with the legendary Whitney Houston and the man who discovered a record producer, Clive Davis. And tomorrow night, she is performing on this very stage. OK, next up, second of the overs and their mentor, Mr. Simon Cowell.
I am very happy to introduce the extremely talented Daniel Johnson.
You don't have the likability factor.
One of the best performances I've ever heard in my life. Daniel.
Saturday night was really scary, and all I was thinking about was that massive note at the end.
Between confidence and cockiness.
When the judges said their comments, you just hope that the audience at home don't feel the same.
I thought it was an incredible performance last week. He was good, and they're worried about him. They're threatened by him.
I'm not, like, a cocky person. I'm confident, as we all have to be to get up onto that stage, but I'm not cocky at all. I'm just performing. I just don't want to go home. When I was a kid, I used to watch music videos continuously, and I used to just copy what they were doing and drive my parents insane. I was just singing in my bedroom, and now I'm singing on The X Factor. It's like a dream come true.
Daniel likes challenges, and I've given him a huge challenge. I've given him a Whitney Houston song nobody's ever heard of. It's from the new record, so I had to get permission for Daniel to perform it.
So, Daniel,
yeah,
you want to sing I Didn't Know My Own Strength, huh?
Which is your song.
It really means a lot to me that you do this well.
I was absolutely petrified. I love this song, and I really don't want to let anyone down with it.
You're losing a little bit of the melody.
Yeah, I would suggest you go back and listen to that song and really know the melody and stick to it.
I just want to do her and Clive proud and just show that, you know, I can connect and make this song work.
I stand by what I said to Daniel last week. I think he had got to that point where he was verging on cocky. Undoubtedly, he gave a good performance. But for me, having the X Factor is about more than that.
An artist is supposed to have confidence.
They said it's cocky. It's not cockiness, it's confidence.
Hopefully I'll get the chance to show them a different side of me and hopefully change their opinions around.
Samuel Johnson!
When my soul, I have nowhere to turn, I have nowhere to go. The side of my dream, thought it would be the end of me. I thought I'd never make it through. I had no hope to hold on to. I thought I would break. I didn't know my own strength, and I crashed down, and I tumbled, but I did not crumble. I gave it through the pain. I didn't know my own strength, to my darkest hour, my faith can be alive. Pick myself back up, held my head high. I wasn't built to break. I didn't know my own strength. There were so many times I wondered how I'd make it through the night. Thought I took all that I could take.
Wondering, oh my God, is he going to peak on this first audition? Where does he go from there? But I have to say, that was flawless.
Yes! 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 Thank you, Danny.
I mean, talk about challenging yourself, Daniel. To come out here and sing a Whitney Houston song that's not well known is one big challenge, and I think, I have to say, you delivered.
I'm trying to impress you guys. I'm trying to impress you guys.
You know, Daniel, as you didn't exactly get rave reviews in that room, did you? But, you know, I understand that it's a precious song to Whitney. I chose the song out of respect for this record because I love the song. I think the lyrics said it all. I didn't crumble. I didn't know my own strength. It was, once again, an incredible performance.
Thank you so much. Right.
Man, you don't make life easy for yourself, do you? Pick a Whitney song, she's there, she says go and listen to the melody. No one's ever heard of the song before, it's an album track, and then you come and nail it. How'd you feel?
It's a brilliant song, you know, it's a brilliant song, and it's a pleasure to sing it, and it's a pleasure to have Clive here as well, you know, I feel honoured. So I'm glad everyone loved it.
Great stuff. All right, yeah, tough week last week, going 901, 61, 61, 106, the number you need to become this teacher's pet. Wait till lines open for the end of the show. For now, it's Daniel Johnson. We love that. Coming up, Cheryl told him he was a little pop star last week, but at 16, how will Lloyd cope with a Leona song? Plus, it's Britain's most talked about twins in a performance you don't want to miss. John and Edward, stay right where you are. Welcome back to the X Factor! Next up, back to the boys and their mentor, Cheryl Cole.
So next up, with a massive, massive challenge, is Little Lloyd.
You are a born pop star.
You're going to have a lot of girls crying, a lot of rivers.
Lloyd!
Saturday night was the most amazing night of my life. Nerves were just like shooting up in my spine. I remember thinking, right, Lloyd, show everyone you're a pop star.
Lloyd looked like a pop star, he sang like a little pop star, and I felt like he'd arrived.
Ever since I was a little kid, I always sung. When I was at primary school, I used to sing all the school plays. I even entered the choir and everything. As soon as I got to high school, I just stopped singing. A bit embarrassed, really. But it was always inside me that that's what I wanted to do.
Hello, Lloyd, how are you?
Really good, thanks. Meeting Whitney and Clive Davis was amazing.
You've got a great tone to your voice, don't you think?
You've got the challenge of making the listener feel that you're feeling it. Yeah. You've got to strike that raw nerve.
But if I'm singing, like, the greatest love of all, you know what I'm saying, I find myself standing still and getting into, like, I believe the children are our future. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Taking your time with it, you know what I'm saying? Just stand still sometimes. It's all right.
I think that's great advice because I get to focus more on the song and that's exactly what I've got to do.
I've given Lloyd this week Leona Lewis's probably biggest hit.
For a 16-year-old boy to be given this song, of all songs, I really understand why Lloyd feels worried.
This is one of those songs where it's either make or break, and that just keeps going through my head.
Forget Leona Lewis ever sung this song, right? I think it's your song. Somebody just wrote it for you. I stand by my decision with Lloyd 100%, and tonight he's going to show why.
This could be a disaster.
I'm going to give everything I got.
Twice was enough and it was all in vain. Time starts to pass before you know it, you're frozen. Ooh, something happened for the very first time with you. My heart melted to the ground, felt something true. And everyone's looking around thinking I'm going crazy. But I don't care what they say, I'm in love with you. They try to pull me away, but they don't know the truth. My heart's crippled by the vein that I keep on closing. You cut me open and I keep bleeding. I keep bleeding love. I keep bleeding. I keep bleeding love. I keep bleeding. I keep in love, you cut me open. I don't care what they say, I'm in love with you. They try to pull me away, they don't know the truth. My heart's crippled by the pain that I keep on closing. You cut me open and I
Houston, that must have just been incredible. And I agree with her, you have the most beautiful tone to your voice. We got to hear that, especially in the verses and the bridge. The chorus, I thought you could have gone for it more. I think there's more to your voice, and you've got to push yourself every week to get those big moments. Get lots of them in there.
Thank you so much.
Lloyd, look, you're very, very lucky that you are cute and that the chicks are going to love you. Because if I'm being honest with you, that song would have worked if it had lasted 15 seconds. Once you went into the chorus, it's true, it's like a mouse trying to climb a mountain. It's just too big. And I am going to put the blame, I'm afraid, with the girl on my right, who right now is not working with you properly, understanding you properly, and giving you the right material to survive and do well within this competition. Because I do think you're talented. Very, very, very likable, but you're not being directed properly at the moment.
Thanks, Anna.
Okay.
Sorry.
I'm gonna take full responsibility for the song I gave you tonight. I found it really tough this week. It was a diva week, and I haven't let you down, I'm sorry.
You're welcome. Okay. Lloyd, what do you
want to
say?
I appreciate all your comments and I'll take them all into consideration. But shit, don't get upset, honestly. Don't be proud.
And Simon, that is like, you know, that is the X Factor song from everyone that's graduated from the show. I mean, does he not? He deserves credit for just trying it, doesn't he, Simon?
Good, how do you make me feel? Can you make me feel any smaller than I already feel? I'm only trying to be honest.
No, but I feel...
Come here,
no, I feel
darling.
Responsible.
I'm responsible. Let's just enjoy the moment for a sec. 0901-61-61-107 are numbers you need to tap into your phone and vote for Lloyd. They'll make a certain 16-year-old very happy for doing after all the acts have performed. For now, it's Lloyd Daniels. Time for the groups again now, and two guys who, though it's only the second show, have developed such a great understanding, it's like the carbon copies of each other. It's John and Edward.
It was a musical nightmare.
You're up there giving it a go.
Hey, you entertained everybody.
Biggest moment of our life.
John and Edward.
We can't believe we're still here.
Last week, going out live was incredible.
Coming in from the ceiling, we felt like James Bond on a mission or something.
You can't sing fast.
It was like saying, Dave Beckham, you can't play football.
I did take a chance with you, and I'm glad.
We're so serious about this, okay? This has been our dream since we were little boys, and we want to go all the way in this competition. We've watched singers all our life, and we've always sat at home and gone, wow, I'd love to do that. I remember the very first day, Five came on the telly, and I was like, wow. Imagine if we had that status and had that much fun and able to come out with such a hit.
We love you guys.
This week we turned 18 and we met the one and only Whitney Houston.
Happy birthday. How old are you?
18.
I don't see us being 18.
We don't even have a beard or anything.
Whitney said that Britney's all about the dancing and not just the singing.
Bring it out. Dance. Do your thing.
And don't look at each other too much for that connection.
Sing Britney Spears to her inspiration, Whitney Houston, was fantastic and we'll never forget it.
See you guys. Thanks.
The choreography that Brian Friedman is teaching us is the exact same choreography that he taught Britney Spears.
I don't think I've ever been in a rehearsal and had so much fun. The boys just make me laugh and I can't get enough of them.
If this goes well for us, hopefully people start to believe in us. Above all, we don't want to let Louis down. We want to do this for him. This is a hard song and this is hard choreography, but we're going to go out there tonight and give it everything that we got.
John and Edward singing Britney Spears? Oops.
There's absolutely no way this can work.
Tonight we're going to go out and prove that we can sing back.
Yeah, I think I did it again.
Before you go, I want to give you something. Oh, it's beautiful. But wait a minute, isn't this?
Yeah, yes it is.
But I thought the old lady dropped into the ocean yet.
Well, Letter, I went down and got it for you.
Oh, you shouldn't have.
Oops, I did it again to your heart. Got lost in this game, oh baby. Oops, you think that I'm sent from above. I'm not that innocent. Oops, I did it again. I played with your heart. Got lost in the game. Oh baby, baby. Oops, you think I'm in love. Said I'm sent from above. I'm not that innocent.
Honestly, vocally, it's not right, but it's okay. The Double Divas from Dublin. I wish Louis was here with you. The good news is it's entertaining, it's fun, it made sure a lot.
Yeah.
Go.
Do you know, I have to say, when it comes to Saturday night, the act I'm always most looking forward to is you two. Whether it's right or wrong, you are thoroughly entertaining, and I hope you're staying longer, even if it is just to annoy Simon.
Thank you. Well, my initial reaction was, what the bloody hell was that? guys, arguably... Actually, not arguably, the worst live performance I've ever sat through in all these years of doing the show. But I'm going to give you this. In the same way I reacted to the first time I watched The Exorcist, I didn't like it, but I wanted to watch it again.
Yeah.
And that's how I sort of feel about you. And actually, to be fair to you, even though I was appalled by the performance, I do actually like you now as people, because you are living on another planet, somewhere else entirely, but sort of entertaining in a weird way.
Guys, it was weird, but great. Did you enjoy it?
Yeah. But no, the thing that happened is we were in the middle of... My microphone came off because Eric boxed me in the face.
Oh, so you hit your brother and your own brother hit you in the face.
I had to get on with it, but...
Yeah. Now, also, you're 18 as well this week, guys?
Yeah.
Fantastic
so
stuff. And people say they're not maturing. Unbelievable. 0901 61 61 108 is the number you need to vote for these guys to ensure they have to buy another truckload of hair gel to be on this stage next week. Wait till one's open at the end of the show. Here's John, here's Edward. Together they are John and Edward. Life has taken a turn for the surreal. It was hats off to Ricky last week. He is back up after the break and he's got big hair but even bigger dreams. How will Jamie fare when he takes on Christina Aguilera? We are back in a flash. Welcome back to the X Factor Live Finals. It's only week two, but already shaping up to be quite some contest. Eight acts have exploded onto the stage and stake a claim to the next round, but someone has to go tomorrow night. So, hoping to keep their dream alive, last of the boys and Cheryl.
Next up is my Scottish lad, Ricky Loney.
I'm so glad you came back.
When the doors opened, I was like, this is it. This is it happening. I'm on the live stage.
I can sort of see why you were singing in those pubs.
Thought Simon's comments were out of order.
It was wet. I think that he was a wee bit harsh. My mum's always believed that she would see my name up in lights one day. It was such a proud moment for me.
was always singing as a toddler. I always made sure that I took part in all the school shows, any opportunity, whether it was karaoke machine, I was always there. My mum always used to put hats on me, and that's probably why I continue wearing them now. It was amazing to meet Whitney and Clive Davis as well. This is what dreams are made of. When I first told Whitney that I was singing with Aretha Franklin, she was like, oh, big song.
Singing Aretha song. All I gotta tell you is, you gotta know what you're doing.
Yeah.
She is one of the greats.
That was scary.
I ain't gonna do you wrong while you're gone.
Finished the song and I thought I did it well.
My mother, she's on that record, so I know it so well, I can sing it in my sleep.
I was like, wow.
You are really talented. This song is very, very tough.
There was nobody like her, so nobody really can mess with Aretha.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Whitney says, oh, you know, you've got to know what you're doing with this song.
Good luck to you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. I'll just need to go out there and show that I can do it justice.
Every single thing you could want in a diva song is there, and that's why it's such a good song, when it's good.
He has to do something which is going to push him, because otherwise I think he'd be out of the competition.
This song's going to give Ricky the opportunity to be back in this competition and prove that he is a real contender.
I'm not just a pub and club singer, and I'm not wait, and I'm not going to let it go without a fight.
And I see kind of a little bit of Will Young performance in you. You're really working the stage very well. I thought vocally it kicked in towards the end, so you've got to make sure that you grab us right from that opening line.
Okay.
Ricky, I will give you respect because I think what you did tonight took a lot of guts because it was quite clear from meeting Whitney and Clive that they weren't supportive of the song choice. Unfortunately, they were right. The song was far, far, far too big for you. I think, in my opinion, you went from a pub singer to a wedding singer in a week because you're just not connecting at the moment, and it's probably to do with song choice, to be honest with you. And the girls were terrific, by the way, but just the way you were dancing and singing together, it was uncomfortable. It just, it's not working for me at the moment. Well, it wasn't bad, but it wasn't great.
First of all, I'm going to say thank you so much for taking the song choice on. I know you weren't totally comfortable with it. I know that we've all found it hard being a diva week, and the comments from Clive and Whitney knocked you a bit, but I thought you did a fantastic job of it.
Buddy, I tell you what, tough week for you. Big, big song.
Massive song.
And, you know, Whitney said it probably wasn't a wise choice. What are your thoughts?
You know, Cheryl gave me the song, and I took her advice. You know, she is obviously the expert, and I was like, I'm going to try this, and I'm going to give it the best I can do. And Whitney didn't agree with it, but I came out here and I think I've done the best I can do with it.
OK, what do you want to say back to Simon? Because I know, you know, Simon's got some forthright opinions about yourself at the moment.
You know, Simon, just give me a wee bit of respect. So see you next week. Hopefully I can get something.
I just
something
better. Ricky, I said at the top, I will give you respect for bravery. No point lying to you. Yeah. This is all about giving people an opportunity, and I don't think you're being advised properly at the moment.
0901 61 61 109 is the number you need for Ricky. You want to vote for him, make a note of it and get on the line when the line's open at the end of the show and not before. For now, it's Ricky Lonely, everyone. Last of the overs in the competition now. Simon, who have you got for us?
I'd just like to say to Whitney, if you're watching, by the way, you look very cute. So, she does. It's gorgeous. Anyway, back to the competition. It is... I've completely lost my way now.
Yeah,
Jamie.
Jamie, go the pro!
It was a different league from everything else.
Jamie!
Walking onto stage for the first time, it feels like a dream come true for me.
I just hope you're going to be more versatile.
When Louis said that he thought I wouldn't be versatile, that was really hurtful. I want to show everybody else that there's much more to me than just going up there and playing big rock tunes. Since the age of 10, when my dad gave me my first guitar, I've always known that I wanted to be a musician. And I was so shy that I guess I found some sort of refuge in music. It's kind of been my friend throughout thick and thin. It's the only thing I've ever really wanted to do.
Hello.
Hello, Jamie.
How are you doing?
I will never forget the day that I met Whitney Houston. Just incredible.
You are my favourite female singer of all time. And yeah, I think you're amazing.
Thank you.
Mr. Cool Guy, Jamie Afro, went completely out the window and was replaced by a quivering wreck.
If I had just one more day.
You have to think about what you're singing. You just feel the lyric, what it means to you.
The more intense you are, the more you're going to get from that lyric line.
When Whitney Houston advises you how to sing, you listen, you know. Tonight I'm singing a song from Christina Aguilera. I think it's going to surprise a few people.
It's arguably one of the hardest songs in the world to sing, and it will either be brilliant or an unmitigated disaster.
Jamie's performance this week is completely different than anything he has done before.
Jamie's out of his comfort zone because this song isn't about rock vocals. It's all about the emotion.
I'm going to have to put my heart and soul on stage tonight and show everyone really who I am.
Seems like it was yesterday that I fell away. You told me how proud you were, but I walked away. If only I knew what I know today. I would hold you in my arms. I would take the pain away. Thank you for all you've done. Forgive all your mistakes. There is nothing I couldn't do just to hear your voice again. Sometimes I wanna call you, but I know you won't be there.
about hurting you. Yeah, if I had just one more day, I would tell you how much that I missed you since you went away. Oh, it's dangerous. You're so out of line to try.
When the audience comes in, from rehearsals today to now, that was a massive, massive difference. Love it when you really rock out. You brought a lot of softness to that song. Well done.
Thank you.
Yeah, I totally agree with Danny. I wasn't sure about this in rehearsals, if I'm honest. At the start, I still wasn't sure, but I think by the end, you totally made it your own, and it was a great song choice.
You're so unenthusiastic, you two, tonight. I thought that was absolutely fantastic. And, you know, Jamie, I'll tell you why I really, really like that. Because that, for me, it felt real, it felt honest, and most importantly, I think... I did choose it, yeah, but it works... That works in the real world outside of this competition. There lies the difference. Brilliant.
Someone's got to be happy. Way to go, Jamie. How'd you feel?
Top of the world. I wanted to prove that I was more than just some pub rocker, and I hope that tonight I did.
It's like you scored a goal at the end, though, getting a high five and Simon. Way to go, buddy. 0901-61-61-110. Dial that number and you vote for this guy. It's as simple as that. Lines will be open after tonight's final act. For now, it's Jamie Archer, everyone. After the break, the diva of Dagenham hits the stage as Stacey takes on Beyonce, and very soon, lines open for your votes. We'll see you in a tick. Hello and welcome back to The X Factor. 10 acts have sung their hearts out for your votes. One more waiting in the wings to perform before we open the lines. Closing the show, last of the girls. Danny, who's up?
Well, last week it was Dagenham Stace, but as it's Diva Week, it's Stacey from Dungeon Harm.
You've got it all. You have no idea how good you potentially could be.
Saturday, just before I walked out on stage, I felt ill, like, oh, my stomach was bubbling. I was like, oh, no. The music starts, and then you start singing, and that's it. Like, you just enjoy it.
You're a natural pop star.
I'm so glad we just got to hear you sing so beautifully tonight.
It's really nice to get good comments from the judges, and it's nice to make Danny proud.
I was so proud of Stacey last week. She really couldn't have done it any better.
I've been singing since I can remember, all the time, everywhere. I used to sing like Whitney Houston and the Spice Girls all the time, in the back of the car, in the house, everywhere we went. My friends were just like, shush. And once I had to sing at a family wedding, Because You Love Me by Celine Dion. I was like 12. It was so embarrassing. No one ever tells us anything. So we just come to a hotel and we're like, oh, you're meeting Whitney Houston. I'm like, oh, gosh, I look like a tramp. Yeah. I don't know, not a penny money.
Oh, don't worry, I didn't pay mine either.
Love is love.
Very good.
use your arms. Just let it go, you know?
So it seems that it's taken over you. And just get into it from the start, because this becomes a classic.
I think my biggest challenge is just to, like, really get into the song and, like, let it be me. Hopefully it'll be a bit easier without Whitney and Clive staring at me in the face. I love the song Danny's chosen for me tonight. It's an amazing song. I just don't know it at all. I was like, oh my gosh, I can't be forgetting the words.
I really love Stacey, but if she gets out there tonight and she forgets the words, nobody's safe.
I'm not worried. Stacey was incredible last week, and tonight she's going to be even better.
Like, sometimes I really get it, and sometimes I just don't. Tomorrow I'm just going to really, really hope that I do it well.
It sounded like you totally got into the zone and that you knew that song really well, so well
thanks.
Done. Great.
Stacey, look, this is both a positive and a negative, is that you are so out of your comfort zone at the moment, it's unbelievable, because you look tonight like you've been plonked in that dress, made to sing a song which you don't particularly know. The first part didn't really work. And then in the last 20 seconds or so, you kind of got it together. But my advice to you is that you should just be doing your own thing. There was something a little bit uncomfortable about the performance tonight compared to last week. Yeah. And by the way, I'd also like to... I would also like to thank Clive, Whitney, thank you very much indeed for what you did. And Louis, we miss you. But well done, Stacey.
Stacey, it was a beautiful performance. I know that you didn't know the song, but, you know, it's an exposing performance. You got into it. You smashed it at the end of the song. That was just... And we have to remember that you've just turned 20 and you've come from literally singing in your bedroom to now performing on this stage, and it's what's uncomfortable about your performance, which is your entire charm. I love it.
Thanks. How did you feel doing it tonight? I mean, how did you feel out there?
Oh, I loved it, but sorry, I didn't look comfortable. Can't play them all.
It's literally like a different person takes over when she sings with the makeup. And Simon, how can you say, look at that dress, people, come on. All right, 0901 61 61 111 is a number you need to call if you want to be very popular with Stacey tonight. Votes cost 35p from a BT landline. Mother networks may vary from mobiles, will be considerably more. This, ladies and gentlemen, closing the show is Miss Stacey Solomon. All right, what a night, and this is it. The vote is now open and will close in tomorrow night's results show. Sky and Virgin Media viewers can vote using their red buttons. Votes cast after lines have closed won't be counted but may still be charged. The finalists tried to raise their game tonight and win votes, but now it's down to you. So, to vote for Lucy, the number to call, 0901 61 61 101 at 02 if Ollie was your favourite, 03 if you like Miss Frank. To give Rachel your vote, but an 04 in the end, it's an 05 to vote for Joe. And if you want Daniel to sing again, it's 06. 07 on the end for Lloyd, and an 08 if John and Edward did it for you. 09 for Ricky, and a 10 on the end for Jamie. For Stacey, it is 11 at the end of the number. It's been a brilliant night. We've seen some great performances. The acts have given everything, but come what may, one will leave tomorrow night. So, who are you backing? Here's a reminder of all of the performances tonight and the numbers you need.
Tell you how much that I missed you since you went away. I found a free
for you. Britain, you have 24 hours and counting to keep in your favourite. These guys face an agonising wait as tomorrow night one act will leave the X Factor. Plus, two huge superstar guests as Here Come the Girls, stepping out from behind the desk and launching a solo career, our very own Cheryl Cole. And a massive exclusive. She has been away for over a decade. Tomorrow she is back on this very stage. Whitney Houston. Woo! Houston, we do not have a problem. For exclusive videos and gossip, X Factor, itv.com/X Factor. Right now, Holly's over on ITV2 with the Extra Factor. We see you tomorrow, 7:45. See you then.
So, who are you backing then? Cool, tough choice, isn't it? You can catch all those performances again on the website where we're chatting with Ollie and Daniel as well. Here next, a man who hit the headlines for his performances on and off the court, Boris Becker, is on Piers Morgan's Life Stories.